Welcome back, everybody, to another episode on the channel. Today's episode, guys, I'm going to be going over my top five summer bass fishing lures for really, really hot days. I did a top five summer bass fishing lures just for the summer in general, but now we're kind of moving into those really, really hot days where we have 80 degree weather, 90 degree weather, sometimes in the 100 degrees. I mean, where it's super, super hot out when you're out there. Those water temps can get way up and fishing can get really tough, not only just, you know, on the fish and trying to find fish, but on you mentally. So, you know, I'm gonna go over my five lures. These are not in any particular order, so when I go through these five, just remember they're not in any particular order. We're gonna kind of break down the thought process before, you know, for each individual lure and bait here, and kind of go through why I use it and where I use it. Before we jump into that video, guys, today's video is actually sponsored by Super K Jigs. So if you guys have never heard about Super K Jigs, I use their jigs religiously. So Super K Jigs, guys, is a local company around my area, and they make any kind of jigs, swim jigs, flipping jigs, terminal tackle, skipping jigs, pretty much any jig you can imagine, plus some terminal tackle they make. Now, what sets Super K apart from everybody else, guys, is Super K, all of their jigs are hand-tied jigs, guys. So this is one of their swim jigs right here, black and blue in color. The skirts on here are great skirts. They got really good hooks on these jigs as well. I can't say enough about these jigs, but all of the skirts, like I said before, are hand-tied. If you guys have never seen the difference between a hand-tied jig and a jig that is not hand-tied, I guarantee you that jig that is not hand tied is not going to hold up as long as these right here. You spend enough money on tackle, guys, so don't cop out on cheap stuff. Hand tied jigs, Super K jigs, guys. I absolutely love them. I pretty much switched over all my boxes of jigs to Super K jigs because they hold up. I use a swim jig a ton, especially on the Mississippi River, and I get into pike quite a bit. And I'll tell you what, if my swim jig does not get bit off, the skirts hold up against even those big giant pike that have those giant teeth on there. It holds up in that. So Super K Jigs, guys, if you guys have never checked them out, I'm gonna link them down below in the description. Also, I have a code for you guys. If you guys use the code WW20, it's gonna get you guys 20% off of your order. So if you're looking at new jigs or you wanna look at buying some jigs, maybe you've never tried a swim jig, they have every color you could imagine. If they don't have a color that you guys want to use, just email them and they'll work with you guys to get you guys a color that you want. But like I said, I'll link Super K down below. Go check them out, click that link, and then also use the code WW20. It's gonna save you guys 20% off of your order. All right, so now let's get into the video here. Like I said, these lures and baits are for super hot days. We've gotten into some crazy, crazy hot days here lately, and it kind of makes the fishing tough, not only on, like I said before, not only on, you know, the fish, but you mentally when you're out there. And so it helps to know that you're throwing the right baits or you're doing the right things to get those bites. Otherwise, you're starting to question everything. So, like I said, these are in no particular order, guys. I'm just gonna go through the baits that, you know, these are my top five for me personally when it's really, really hot. So when it comes to fishing for bass in the summertime, before I jump into lures really quick, let's talk about it. You got two options. You can either fish them deep or you can fish them shallow. I mean, it's really up to you, and it also depends on the lake and the fishery that you're in. You know, the Mississippi River, there's not a lot of really deep spots to fish, but you can still find some smallmouth on like wing dams and things like that. Those deeper wing dams where they drop down to like 15 to 20 feet, you can find smallies hanging on that kind of stuff. That's where you can fish them deep. You can find some deep holes and stuff like that, or you can fish them shallow. You can fish in that duckweed, thick, matted vegetation, things like that. So a lot of these lures are kind of geared for that. So if I'm personally, let's just start with deep here. Now it kind of depends on my mood. Sometimes I want to fish deep and sometimes I just want to fish shallow, but lately I've actually been wanting to fish deep. Sometimes I'll switch to fishing deep later in the day. It just really depends on what I want to do. But if I'm going to go fish deep, first thing on my list, guys, is going to be a Ned rig. I was out the other day actually, and I busted out this Ned rig when I was off at this rock point that dropped down to like 20 some feet, and I was actually catching them in that. So the first thing that I would suggest for you guys, you know, one of my top five here is going to be, like I said, a Ned rig right here. Usually I go with the 16th to 8th ounce Ned head. And then I throw on just, you know, a Z-Man green pumpkin. I think this is like the Hula stick or something like that. Really, I just stick to green pumpkin. I think it's a great color. I think, you know, it just covers all your bases. I was using like a green pumpkin with a gold and purple flake that I was catching fish on as well. But I think the big thing is the net head, going to that 16th or going to that 8th ounce jig. Lately I've been using a lot of 8th ounce, but a lot of the times with this Ned rig, I just have become a huge fan of the Ned rig this year. It just simply catches fish, especially on those really hot days. Those fish can be finicky, and this small little presentation here can get you quite a few bites. Now, I'm not gonna say it's gonna catch you the biggest fish, because you'll definitely catch a lot of fish off of a Ned rig. You'll still catch good quality fish off of a Ned rig, but you're gonna be sorting through a lot of smaller ones just because of how small the presentation is. So, first on the list, guys, if I'm gonna start fishing deep, especially a lot of rock lately, I will go to a Ned rig. Next on the list, guys, is going to be a crankbait. Now, along with the Ned rig, you know, fishing deep, that's where I'll bust out a crankbait, especially on wing dams. When I'm fishing wing dams on the river, guys, I absolutely love throwing a crankbait. I like to throw a black and chartreuse kind of crankbait. This is just pretty much all chartreuse. Black and red's a really good color as well. But I like to fish wing dams for smallmouth, but crankbaits just cover a wing dam super effectively. You can pretty much, you know, because there's so many different wing dams out on the river systems, you pretty much gotta hop wing dam to find them. So, you know, having a bait like this is a really good way to cover a lot of water. But not only that, if you find deep holes, deep, you know, steep ledges, stuff like that, a deep crankbait is just a great way to go. It's a great way to catch fish, a super easy way to cover water as well. So my next bait on the list after the Ned rig, I will throw out the deep crankbaits. Now, one of my absolute favorite techniques in the summertime, guys, is to throw a giant worm. I don't care how big it is, but a giant ribbon tail worm. These are my, I got these actually in a Monster Bass box, one of my X-Zone series. It's an 11-inch blitz worm. It's just a huge ribbon tail worm here, guys. Look at this thing. This thing is giant. It's one of my favorite techniques is to throw just a giant worm in the summertime. I don't know what it is. If you find yourself a deep hole or just a deep ledge and you're just dragging or dragging this thing even over wing dams or dragging it off of big rock shelves, things like that, just dragging a worm on the bottom. Usually I'll use like a 1/2 ounce tungsten weight, unpeg it, just Texas rig this thing with a 5-aught hook, and I'll just drag the bottom. And I think what it is, guys, is I think that it's just, you get into those situations where the fish just sees a big easy meal like this and they just hammer it. This will catch a big fish. I've caught small fish that are like the size of the worm, if not smaller, eat this thing right here. I think it's just the fact that the presentation is a nice easy meal for them, and that's what they see. They just love it. I like to use this color right here. This is kind of like that June bug color. Otherwise, I like to switch it over to a Guggenbaits Mondo worm, and I like to use the black and blue or the green pumpkin. One of the tournaments I won in the summertime last season, I was using a green pumpkin Mondo worm, and that thing was catching me all sorts of fish. But so far, this one from X-Zone, I really like it because of how long the ribbon is on here. The Mondo worm, actually, the majority of the bait is just a big worm and it has a little ribbon at the end. But look at the ribbon on this one right here. This blitz worm, I just love that. It just gives a super nice action in the water. And that is just unique to other worms. So if you guys are looking at picking up 10-inch worms, I would highly recommend these X-Zone Pro Series blitz worms. Get some different colors. This is called Red Bug. It works, this color works really good in clear water. But I mean, I'm fishing a little bit stained water and I've been catching fish off of it. Regardless of it, guys, get yourself a big worm and drag the bottom. I promise you, you will catch some biggins. Now let's transition over into fishing shallow. So when you're fishing deep, guys, like I said before, you know, you got the Ned rig, you got your crankbaits, you got a big worm that you can use. You can fish that in some pretty deep stuff. And I like to, like with that deep stuff, like I said before, I target those rock ledges, those deep holes, those steep wing dams, things like that. But you also have another option, and it's one of my favorite ways to catch fish. You can go up shallow and catch them in the thick of vegetation. Now, usually early morning when I'm getting to the lake or on the river, the first thing that I'm gonna do if I'm gonna go shallow and target fish is I'm gonna fish a frog. A frog is one of my favorite ways to catch fish. I think it just hands down, the frog just does really, really well. Frog is also a great way to cover a lot of water in the summertime, and it's one of my favorite ways to kind of lead into the next bait here. But in the summertime, I'm definitely always throwing a frog. I have a frog tied on all the time, sitting on the front deck ready to go. I fish a frog in the summertime probably 95% of the time. I'm always frogging, unless I just am like, you know what, I'm gonna go fish them deep. Sometimes the frog bite's not working, but in the summertime, guys, I promise you, you get out there early, early morning and you can absolutely hammer fish off of a frog. Leads me into my next bait here. A lot of times you'll be fishing this frog and you'll be in some thick matted vegetation and those fish will basically just be swiping at the frog. They won't have the energy in those super hot days to come out and just hammer the frog, it seems like. So they'll swipe at it and they'll constantly be missing this, or they'll grab the tails and bring it down. They just won't be eating the frog efficiently. That is when I switch it up to one of my all-time favorites, and I know I probably said all-time favorite. I love fishing any one of these five right here for fish. But today, this actually paid off for me, is the punch rig right here. So what you have on the punch rig, guys, is you have a bobber stopper. So that little black peg right here is a bobber stopper. Then you have an ounce and a half tungsten weight on there. And then you have a 5-aught flipping hook. And I like to use a rage bug, a black and blue rage bug. I think that just punches really, really well. But this is one of those rigs where if they keep missing the frog, you just take this sucker, you throw in there, you punch right through that mat. And most of the time they'll hit this. Today, they weren't really hitting the frog. I had a lot of fish that were coming up and swirling at it, or I just wasn't getting bit at all. But I knew that they were in that vegetation. It was super hot. It was like, I don't know, like 88 degree water temps, plus it was like 90 degrees out there today. That's when I picked up this punch rig and I just started punching through vegetation and I started getting bite after bite after bite. So that's what you guys wanna do. When the frog bite's not going, but you know they're in that vegetation, bust out a punch rig. It's gonna be one of those rigs that you're gonna have to take some time getting used to because you gotta throw it on a big rod, but I promise you, the punching rig is one of those rigs that I don't think a lot of people use, but it catches fish just hands down. I've caught some absolute toads punching through mats of vegetation. So there you guys have it. Those are my top five lures for fishing those really hot summer days. If you guys have a bait or lure that I did not mention, please leave it down in the comments below. Share that knowledge in the community. These are not the only five that you can use for hot days. It's just what I prefer to use. But like I said, drop it down in the comments. Maybe you'll share something that I'll try and it'll just be absolutely fire. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Like I said, guys, go ahead and check out Super K down below in the description. Click that link and use that discount code for you guys. It's gonna save you guys some money. Hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. Remember to like and subscribe, and we will see you guys on the next one.